we have taken a lot of measures already. Security agencies have already scolded some of them. And we have spoken to the security agencies, I must assure you. The security agencies were awake throughout this morning that I know of. And all parties have been talked to, and I guarantee you, the media that even took that message and gave it maximum publicity does not know what national security management is all about. In countries that are well informed, any newspaper, any radio house, any television that sees something that is inflammatory, that can push a country into fire, and they give it maximum publicity, they know what the law says. But in Nigeria, maybe the paper belongs to one big man who is one of either those contractors or one of those politicians who like trouble. So let's open our eyes very well. But as far as I know, up to the moment that we came, there is nothing to worry about. It is nothing to worry about. There is nothing to worry about. So pass this message. And as I'm passing this message, I please call upon you as leaders, and I know you can do it. Kanu is our son. He's our younger brother. Those talking to Kanu are the ones you will look at, not Kanu himself. The Naira that is flying is the issue. Let's understand that peace and security in our land is priceless. Nobody can buy security. When you have it, protect it. Let there be peace. All parties have been talked to. Yesterday, Ralph Bazuruki and I were always on telephone, and I'm ready to go there so that we can pass messages. Ibo land is our house. Ibo elders are our parents. Yoruba leaders are our parents. Northern leaders are our parents. The younger ones should imbibe the culture of peace so that we can use the environment and grow. But as far as this question is concerned, there is no fear, I guarantee, whatsoever. Thank you.
We shall do everything humanly possible to uphold the honor, the dignity of our people, that these almost inescapable regime of suffocation, of subjugation, of total enslavement of our people must and will come to end in our time. It is not something we are prepared to live with, and we cannot tolerate it.
Biafra is a nation. Igbos are Biafra.
Do you want Biafra?
Yes, I want Biafra.
Why?
Because we have suffered a lot in hands of Nigeria, and we want to have our own freedom.
Do you know what Biafra is?
No.
You don't know what Biafra is?
Mm.
But some people are agitating for Biafra. You support
the border? I'm in support if it will be peace, if there will be a peace, but if there will be a kind of misunderstanding, no. I don't want war.
Why don't you want war?
Because we need peace. Our country needs peace.
There is nothing good about Nigeria because Nigeria has nothing to offer. People in Nigeria are criminals, if you permit me to use that word. Why we really want Biafra is this. We need change.
To my own understanding, is freedom. Yeah. If they will do it in peace, I will like it. Don't want problem, war, of maybe killing people, wasting life. That's no cause. So if the thing will cause problems, better they leave it.
since 1914. The Igbo man have never got a position in our own land since 1914 amalgamation. They never allow Igbo man to be in any good position. Brother, the passenger call us. We are not his brother. He call us rebel. Can check it in the world, it's a record.
I'm one of those that fought and resisted the zoo called Nigeria. I was 13 years when I joined. And because what motivated me most, or most of us that were in school that day, that time, is because of the vandals killed, after killing our people in the northern Nigeria. They had the mind to put these cops and injured people inside the train and shifted them to us for us to see what's happening.
To us, we were pushed away from Nigeria, so we decided to defend ourselves.
You were pushed away?
We were pushed away when there was pogrom in the north. So a lot of people returned. We were praised to the world. We had no any other alternative than to defend ourselves.
Did you fight during the war?
I fought during the war.
As
a signaler. I fought as a signaler under 37th Battalion.
So how was it like? What was it?
It was a horrible situation.
When Biafra come, all these hawkers, all these kidnappers and robbers and stuff, okay. And they give us good road and electricity.
Ma Biafra, ihe dị mkpa ka enyere la m ego ndị mmadụ bịa zụọ m ahịa ka m ri ihe. Ọ ihe dị mkpa ma m Biafra, ma Biafra dị o, ma ọ dịghị amaghị m ka a bịa kpọta ndị ahịa ha zụrụ m ahịa. Ọ ihe dị mkpa.
So ọ dịghị mma ka lụwa kwa ọkụ.
Yeah, what I'm telling them, they say you should come back before 1st October. I'm advising them, you can't stay there. It's only stick you say we kill if you stand. You make a move. We should make a move. It's high time they know where they come from. Yeah, really, really. We have our government should now intervene. Know how to handle these borders when they come in this place. When they come in, our borders, government, we have governors, senators, what are they waiting for? Let us invest here. Most of them, they don't waste here. What they need is to not have to go to North and invest, especially that Abuja side. All of the other investments. Your governor now would like to have investment in Abuja. Do not have anything on my head here. Just imagine you see about good thing here. No, they're not talking about this. See the market. This is market, national or international market. See how loose people have politics. What are you waiting for? Stay shepherding to me.
As for this very proud Igbo race that I happen to come from, by the grace of God, I will do everything humanly possible to serve it with every ounce of dedication in my body, that one day we and our people can sit around and say that this was a fight well fought, and that now that we are free, we can begin to work towards attaining all those potentials that the Most High God gave to us. We shall do everything humanly possible to uphold the honor, the dignity of our people, that these almost inescapable regime of suffocation, of subjugation, of total enslavement of our people must and will come to end in our time. It is not something we are prepared to live with, and we cannot tolerate it.
Biafra is a nation. Igbos are Biafra.
Do you want Biafra?
Yes, I want Biafra.
Why?
Because we have suffered a lot in hands of Nigeria, and we want to have our own freedom.
Do you know what Biafra is?
No.
You don't know what Biafra is?
Mm.
But some people are agitating for Biafra. Are you in support of what they
are? I'm in support if it will be peace, if there will be a peace, but if there will be a kind of misunderstanding. No. I don't want war.
Why don't you want war?
Because we need peace. Our country needs peace.
there is nothing good about Nigeria, because Nigeria has nothing to offer. People in Nigeria are criminals, if you permit me to use that word. Why we really want Biafra is this. We need change.
To my own understanding, it's freedom. Yeah. If they will do it in peace, I will like it. I don't want problem, war, of maybe killing people, wasting life. That's no cause. So if the thing will cause problems, better they leave it.
Since 1914, the Igbo man have never got a position in our own land. Since 1914, amalgamation. They never allow Igbo man to be in any good position. Brother, the passenger call us? We are not his brother. He call us rebel. Can check it in the world, this record.
I'm one of those that fought and resisted the zoo called Nigeria. I was 13 years when I joined. I was 13 years. And because what motivated me most, or most of us that were in school that day, that time, is because of the vandals killed, after killing our people in the northern Nigeria. They had the mind to put these cops and injured people inside the train and shifted them to us for us to see what's happening.
To us, we were pushed away from Nigeria. So we decided to defend ourselves.
You were pushed away?
We were pushed away when there was pogrom in the north. So a lot of people returned. We were praised to the world. We had no any other alternative than to defend ourselves.
Did you fight during the war?
I fought during the war.
As
a signaler. I fought as a signaler under 37th Battalion.
So how was it like? What was it?
It was a horrible situation.
When Biafra come, all these hawkers, all these kidnappers, I don't know about the stuff. Okay. And they give us good road and electricity.
My dear friend, he had them back in the Lamegun, the Maro Biazoma here. Come, I had them by Mamma Biafra, Biafra, you, Mardi, Magamka, Gabia, Botanda, has Roma here, he had them.
So they get Macalo a walk.
Yeah, what I'm telling them, they say you should come back before 1st October. I'm advising them, you can't stay there. It's only stick, you say we kill if you stand. You make a move. They should make a move. It's high time they know where they come from. Yeah, really, really. We have our government should now intervene, know how to handle these borders when they come in this place. When they come in, our borders, we have governors, senators, what are they waiting for? Let us invest here. Most of them, they don't waste here. What they need is to not have to go to North and invest, especially that Abuja side. All of the other investments, your governor now would like to have investment in Abuja. Do not have anything on my head here. Just imagine, you see about good thing here. No, I'm talking about this. See the market. This is market, national or automated market. See how loose people have politics. What are you waiting for? Still chef footing to me.
As for this very proud Igbo race that I happen to come from, by the grace of God, I will do everything humanly possible to serve it with every ounce of dedication in my body, that one day we and our people can sit around and say that this was a fight well fought, and that now that we are free, we can begin to work towards attaining all those potentials that the Most High God gave to us.
Evolution. When I say revolution, I mean every revolution starts by protest. When it starts by protest, at that protest, the power can stop them. They have the ability to stop them. But when it becomes revolution, no one can stop revolution. Revolution means everyone is ready to go for it. This is the one we are seeing other nations all over. I repeat again, I'm seeing what? A revolution. I'm seeing people taking to the streets. At the beginning of that protest, instead of revolution, I said protest is a parable. Yeah, because when it started, you think it's a protest. But at the end of the day, you realize that this is a revolution. You can stop protest, but you cannot stop revolution. Tell your neighbor, you can stop protest, but revolution you cannot stop. You know, every revolution starts by protest. If I'm talking, let us see your hand. It will come, people carry planka, hey, you say, ah, this is protest. You carry police, you carry everything, you stop them. But when it becomes revolution, everybody are ready to die. So you can't stop it. At the beginning of that protest, I call it beginning because at the beginning of every revolution, it looked like protest. It must be stopped at the beginning. Eventually, it will become so big that it cannot be stopped. This I see happen. Nigeria.